this idea was quite a few years in the making. My wife and I, we were in the Army for 8 years, and we traveled to all these different places, and we always experienced different restaurants, different food, and we always asked ourselves the question, why can't we have something like this in Chillicothe? So we kind of got our background, kind of got our feet wet in food with the Dairy Queen, and then an opportunity came up for us to expand what we were trying to do, and we knew we wanted to be downtown. We knew we wanted to contribute to the revitalization of downtown. We're excited to be part of it, and everything kind of spun from there. We're actually in the process right now of redoing our menu. We've been open about 4 months, so it's kind of exciting for us. We've got 4 months of data, and we're starting to get a lot of great feedback from our guests. So we're actually moving our menu right now in a direction of more fresh items. We're really focused on unique things like black raspberry bean dip. We're really pushing a fresh salad program. But we're keeping our staple of things like our burger. Our Machinery Hall burger is one of our best sellers. Our ribeye steak is amazing. So we've kind of got everything from soup, salads, appetizers, all the way up to full entrees.
You know, we've really achieved what we set out to achieve, and that was taking a historic site and making it state of the art, but really maintaining a historic aesthetic. And I think everybody's been really, really happy with that. That's typically what I hear is people walk in and they really look around and they say, wow, we're so happy that this place exists and that, you know, I'm happy to be a part of it.
We have 30 craft draft beers on tap, and then we've got about another 100 beers in the cooler. So we have a pretty extensive beer program. But in addition to our beer program, we've also got a really excellent wine selection and a really excellent liquor selection, including about 12 different premium bourbons. Chillicothe does seem to be a bit of a beer town. We have a house beer. It's kind of funny. When we first started the concept, people thought we were going to brew beer here. And that was never really part of the concept. That was a bridge farther than we wanted to go. But so in order to kind of satisfy that demand, we partnered with North High Brewery in Columbus, and they're brewing a beer for us that we call Poorhouse Own, and that's actually our number one selling beer. It's a honey wheat lager. It's designed to be palatable for somebody that's a typical Bud Miller Coors drinker that's used to light beer. So it's a good segue from Bud Miller Coors into the craft beer segment. One of the things that we also wanted to do was be a live entertainment venue. So our mission is to eat better, drink local, and live social. So part of living social is we wanted to create an environment where people felt comfortable, families, friends, old acquaintances, new friends, where everybody felt like they could come together and have great food, great beverage, and a welcoming social environment. So part of that is our entertainment program. So we have a stage, and we're really pushing live music here. We've had comedy acts. In the future, we're looking at different entertainment things that we can do to keep things fresh and interesting. But for us, it's more than just being a restaurant. It's more than just being a bar. We're all about trying to provide a great atmosphere for everybody to feel like they have a welcoming place at the Poorhouse. So we get a lot of great feedback on our facility. We get a lot of great feedback on our staff. We get a lot of great feedback on our beverage program. And admittedly, the area that we're working hard to improve is our food program. And that's part of the reason that we're revisiting the menu and taking guest feedback and figuring out what we can do better. And that's really our goal, is to give everybody a better experience today than they had yesterday.